What is up, everybody? It is Hobbs Horror here, and we're doing our final day of the Wild Eye Week. Man, has it been a blast. I've had a wonderful time doing this with everybody. Here's a list of shout-outs to everybody that's doing these, but more specifically, I want to thank Bronco Juggalo Talks Movies for giving us this opportunity to do this with him this year, and it's been an absolute pleasure. I've really enjoyed Wild Eye Week. Kudos to Bronco Juggalo Talks Movies, Tim Horror Devil 333, my boy Bones, Mr. Bones, Horrific Nightmares JM, The Q's Reviews, The Horror Man, Dave Maggot, Horror Freak 85 2.0, Horror Culture TV is also doing these. I know Andy's Entertainment, I believe, is doing these as well. If I've missed anybody, it's completely on accident. All of us that have been doing these, kudos to you guys. This has been fun. And anyways, on to the final movie. This film is called Dark Slide. It came out in 2020, starring Sean Gray, Chris Bleisman, and Rene Dorian. And this also goes by a different name as well, Road to Red. So this particular film is 2 hours long, just slightly over 2 hours long. And I'll be honest with you, I've been holding back on this one for a very long time. In fact, the person that gave me this film was none other than Bronco Juggalo Talks Movies. I think we did a trade, if I'm not mistaken, or he just sent this to me in part of a package. And I really appreciate that, man. Sorry I've been putting this one off. I just didn't want to do 2 hours. But I'm glad that I did, because this film was entertaining. And let me explain why. So, what you have here is you have a group of friends that are skaters, extreme skaters. They are surfers. They're looking for that next fix to be able to, you know, catch on to something, improve something. One of the brothers is working on a better way to skateboard and incorporate that into their surfing style. So basically, you know, how can we improve the way that we're surfing to make it feel more like it's a skateboard? So unfortunately, that brother ends up becoming missing and he's believed to have been dead. So this group of friends decide to go on a road trip, one to hunt for him, and two to kind of get away from it all. And, you know, they also want to film a documentary on the way there, make a movie. There's a whole bunch of side plots to it as well. The one guy's brother's there, and he's just trying to get some peace and some closure. So they finally raise enough money to do all of this, get themselves out of debt, and take this big road trip, which, you know, they had to do some stuff that you got to do sometimes to make some money. So a little dope, right? So anyways, they made enough money to be able to go on this road trip. And, you know, they get to this location and, you know, they're skating and they find like a huge hill to go down. And towards the end of the hill, there's this divot and the divot goes into a cave. Well, inside the cave, they all fall into it, and they're basically locked down in the cave with this guy. I'm probably giving too much on this, but I'm just giving you a heads up because I don't want this film to be missed. This was fantastic. And while they're down in there, they've got to try to find a way to survive versus the cave killer, basically, the guy that's trying to go after them. And it was really entertaining. Also, this comes from a recommendation from Horrific Nightmares JM, who loved this film, put it up there as one of his top favorite Wild Eye films. So let's get to the pros and cons of the film. The only con I really have to the film was the length of the film and some of the scenes they used for the surfing and the skating. Almost like they had to repeat. They could have cut some of that out and cut this film down by easily 20 minutes. Again, I like the film. They don't need to cut it down, but if they would have done that, it might have suited more people Based on the reviews in the IMDb, some people were kind of put off by that. I get the sense that a lot of people stopped it at about an hour and 10 minutes in because they didn't realize that this was actually a horror film. And once you get to that point, oh man, it becomes great. It's just the sense of survival, the special effects, the makeup, the acting was fantastic in this movie. You really felt for the characters. And it was just special. Now, the budget was $3 million. I could see where they came up with a lot of that. I can see where they would have spent that at, too. You know, I know parts of it was filmed in Portugal. Other parts of it was filmed in the U.S. But this one's highly recommended, guys. Go check out Dark Slide if you're not already. But do it when you can plan some time to watch the whole film. Because to get the full story, you really need to watch the whole film. Because there's a lot to it. So, anyways, guys, this has been a blast. And I love Wild Eye Films. I'll put the link to their channel and also their website in the description. Go check out their films. Continue to support them. They put out a lot of great stuff. Of course, not every single film is going to be a gem. But, you know, they're always fun to me. And, again, I want to thank everybody that's doing these, including Bronco Juggalo Talks Movies. Thank you for having us, my friend. And, Rob, if you're watching this from Wild Eye, thank you. Thank you for supporting all of us and letting us review those movies for you. We really appreciate it. And we'll always do our best to support Wild Eye. And again, this is Hobbs from Hobbs Horror. I may not be doing a Wild Eye Wednesday next week because, you know, I've pretty much gone through most of my Wild Eye films. But I will get back to it eventually. And hope you guys have a great weekend. Catch up with you later. This is Hobbs. Go check out Dark Slide. Peace.